Blackstone Publishing presents No Planet B, a teen Vogue guide to the climate crisis, edited by Lucy Diavolo. This book is read by Joniece Abbott-Pratt, Suzie Althens, Jesse Vilinsky, Frankie Maria Corzo, Kyla Garcia, Lauren Ezzo, Tavia Gilbert, Kelsey Navarro, Sura Sue, Natalie Naudus, Soneela Nankani, David Sadzin, and Shaun Taylor-Corbett.
Foreword. Lindsay Peoples Wagner, May 2020. When I started at Teen Vogue as an intern at the age of 17, there was almost no mention of climate change and sustainability in any print or online issues. But when I came back as editor-in-chief a decade later in 2018, it was clear that climate change was an urgent issue that required thorough coverage, especially for our young, engaged readers. A common misconception I often hear when older people talk about young people's passion for making change is that they're naive and alarmist, or that climate activism is over the top and distracting. What those older people fail to realize is that for young people, it's tough to consider what their future looks like if the future of the planet is uncertain. If we destroy our planet, we have nowhere else to go. There is no planet B. The evidence of climate change is now too copious for even the biggest skeptics to deny with any credibility. We have compelling depictions of how our planet would deteriorate if sea levels continue to rise. We've already seen devastating increases in unpredictable weather patterns like droughts, which in turn create situations like famine. And all the while, ecosystems and species are still depleting rapidly. Simply put, as the planet gets hotter and we stand idly by, we are designing our destiny a fatality. Too often, it takes things getting worse for things to get better. And too often, our broader culture can only see how bad things are getting through a white gaze. Back in 2016, when Mari Copney was only 12 years old, she became an activist on behalf of Flint, Michigan, because of the discolored and undrinkable water, an environmental health crisis created by the city's power brokers. Thousands of children were exposed to lead and at risk for developing severe long-term health issues. And that same year, Native American youth stood tall against the Dakota Access Pipeline that would endanger sacred sites and water supplies. More recently, voices like Greta Thunberg, Jamie Margolin, Shia Bastida, and more have spoken truth to power and demanded justice for the climate. It wasn't until this recent surge of activism in 2019, after weekly school strikes, student-led global days of action demanding action and accountability, and the largest gathering of youth protesters in history, that the world collectively started to take the issue seriously. In the process, they helped reframe the public's understanding of the environment as a justice issue. Climate activist Elsa Mengistu said it best, "If we don't work on climate justice, then we can't work on any kind of justice. Protecting the planet is also about protecting the people on it. The time for action is now. Young people have shown they're ready to lead the fight against climate change. Even as they do the necessary grassroots work in every corner of our planet, they continue to insist on global action. To have an equal society and livable planet for all people, we desperately need to understand how climate destruction impacts people from all walks of life. I hope that this book embodies Teen Vogue's motto of making young people feel seen and heard all over the world. I hope that it forces their parents, communities, loved ones, friends, and most importantly, those in power, to see that the health of our planet depends on how quickly and drastically we change our behaviors. I hope it forces them all to respond. Young people are no longer the future, asking for permission to make changes when it's their turn. Young people are the right now. They are the present, actively changing our future for the better on their own.
Introduction. How climate justice became a pillar of intersectional youth activism. Lucy Diavolo. May 2020. My first day on the job as a political news editor at Teen Vogue was February 20, 2018, 6 days after a shooting at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida, shocked the world. It was an intense time to begin covering politics for a teenage audience, full of heartbreaking stories and gut-wrenching details that were part of a larger, horrible picture about the nature of gun violence in this country. Through the ensuing weeks and months of coverage of an issue that has stalked entire generations now, what kept me moored amid the churning seas of official inaction and policy debate was the rock-solid anchor provided by youth activists from Marjorie Stoneman and the young people in communities all across the country they partnered with to expand the public's understanding of gun violence. It was a trial by fire for me, but was emblematic of how youth activism and organizing has always been the lifeblood of Teen Vogue's political coverage. By the time the Parkland anniversary rolled around in 2019, our political conversation had shifted. Activists trying to prevent gun violence were still hard at work, but the media's focus had largely turned to a presidential election getting underway and the continued broadcasts of the narcissistic bluster coming out of the White House. At Teen Vogue, as we continued our mission of documenting youth activism, that still meant publishing stories about gun violence, but it also meant the chance to cover other kinds of activism more in depth. The climate crisis had always been a key plank in our coverage, thanks to Ali Maloney, Teen Vogue's first-ever digital politics editor. This was evident in the December 2018 editorial package, Plastic Planet, which covered the myriad ways plastic is destroying the world, and much of which is included in this book. Thanks to Ali's work, the climate was already a priority for us by the time we covered Greta Thunberg for the first time ever that same month, December 2018. Little did I know then that when I asked one of my most reliable news writers, Emily Block, to cover a fiery speech at a United Nations climate change summit, the young woman who schooled world leaders would become the focal point of a resurgent climate justice movement, and that I'd get to interview her for a special issue cover story. Luckily for all of us, the movement is much bigger than Greta. Alongside senior politics editor Allegra Kirkland, executive editor Samita Mukhopadhyay, and editor-in-chief Lindsay Peoples-Wagner, who made our cover shoot with Greta happen on a wing and a prayer, I've watched as youth-led organizations completely reset the urgency and often the stakes of our conversations about the climate crisis. While only Greta was named Time's 2019 Person of the Year, the new publicity for a movement all around her was very real. And in our efforts to cover it, we've tried to be as representative as we can of its expansiveness. To recreate this for this book, I've organized the Teen Vogue pieces reproduced here into three sections: reporting, activism, and intersectionality. The first is a section of reporting intended to put the science first, not just the numbers in isolation, but spelling out what it all means. Knowledge is a form of power, and equipping the public with important information gives the people the power to respond to the world around them. For our readers, that means assuming that someone is in the know, but never shaming someone who might not be. It means expanding, contextualizing, and connecting information and delivering it in a way that makes people want to keep reading and to share what they learn. Ali captures the ethical imperatives that drive this facts-first mode of operation, laying out how we followed the lead of youth activists, organizers, and journalists. The second section is about activism, the engine that has propelled our climate coverage forward. For us, journalism is often a conversation with the youth activists and organizers, not just giving them solid reporting, but following their lead on what stories matter and how we should be discussing them. Allegra offers her perspective on documenting the moment 2019 presented and how it fits into the larger arc of climate activism, dating back to the 1970s and beyond. The third and final section is not focused on an activity.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.